Alright, hello everyone. I am going to try to do a demo on Facebook Live. I haven't really done it on this platform yet, so we'll see. Let's see. I'm going to go with a very centered composition. And I'm painting some daisies. I know I have a tendency to shorten objects, so I'm going to try to make this a little bit longer. That's our cat, Cuda. Hi, Ellen. If anyone's watching that is part of the Art Refuge group, can you share it there? I wasn't sure how to do that and share it to my friends. So I'm looking for the center point. So when I use my hands like this, I use it as a really rough composition finder just to see where everything is. Make sure nothing's falling off the page. These daisies are my favorite flower to paint, I think, just because they have really nice shapes, simplified. And I'm using a Colorace non-photo blue pencil just because I don't want it to show through. But I know a lot of people in my workshop didn't really like them because they're too light. So keep that in mind if you want to try them. Some cool shadows going on here because I have multiple light sources. Thank you, Sergio. All right, I can't really see the comments because I have to turn around every time, so I'll try to keep a lookout, but if I don't respond, it's not personal. I'm gonna start with the really bright saturated spots. So I'm using a watered down paint. And today I'm using gouache. In case you're wondering, I've been playing around with casein. I'll be sharing a video that I took yesterday on that. And what I'm doing is I'm looking for the very saturated colors, the very saturated yellows that are hitting this warm studio light that I have. My voice has been kind of froggy lately, so I'm going to try to keep that to a minimum. So I'm not super accurate, as you can probably tell. Just popping color in. Nothing is permanent at this point because it's pretty loose. I want to get in some of these stems. I'm mixing a Viridian green with some Linden green and a little bit of burnt sienna. I'm just going to block these in. I like to work the whole painting at once. So I don't work on one spot at a time. I kind of try to fill it all in as fast as possible and then work in circles. And I noticed in the water, the greens are a lot warmer. And the stems are a little bit bigger, not quite as sharp looking. I don't have my paper towels. Here they are. And I have splatters of paint everywhere. That's how quickly and sporadically I'm working. I want to get some of these shadows in. So I'm mixing kind of a gray almost. This is just nice because it defines the lighting. The hidden flower back here. And I like these specific colors of daisies because the ones in shadow are really subdued and pushed back. Almost have a bit of a green tint to them. Still working very watery. There are really bright spots of red, like a reddish orange. So I'm mixing some cadmium free yellow deep and what is that? Some kind of warm red. I always mix my colors up a little bit. Like I'm never using the exact same color. I'm not very picky. I use what's available. Popping in some back here. And there's some between the petals. Adding a little bit of ultramarine blue for a darker shade for the center flower. Might as well do the other centers. I'm squinting, looking back here. I realize I'm not making the most sense when I'm talking and painting, so I'm sorry. It's something that you can easily fall out of practice. So, there we go. All right. I'm gonna go with a bigger brush now and try to block in the background. So this is my 1.5 inch flat. I usually try to work with as big of a brush as possible. I'm gonna clear off my palette a bit since it has all these really bright colors. And the background I'm gonna do is really light, so I don't want a bunch of muddy colors in here. Okay. Let's start with the light areas, which are going to be warm because my studio light is warm. There is natural light, which is cool, especially because it's a cloudy day. But you'll see that in a little bit. Blocking it in. Kind of looking at the negative space, which is the space around. Adding a touch of red. trick with painting glass is to keep it simple. My wash is pretty light still, and I'm going in to all this. I don't mind if I'm going over some of these stems. I'm going to go over them again. I'm just looking to cover all the white. I had some paint from another painting that bled over, but that's okay. I can easily get rid of it. I'm gonna have to scrub it out a bit. And since it's gouache, it will reactivate with water, so this part might be a little more green. I don't think anyone's gonna notice too much. And I'm rotating my brush to get different strokes. It takes some practice. I know a lot of people have trouble with it at first, but you'll get used to it. Okay, I'm adding a little bit of ultramarine and some yellow ochre. It's kind of a gray, yellowish gray. I'm going to block in this shadow that I'm seeing coming behind. And it's a little bit mixed. It's not purely dark. A little more blue. This blue shadow is actually pretty gray, but relative to the orange and yellow flower, it looks more blue, I would say. Still just trying to fill in all the whites. And then I chose a grayish blue for the bottom, just because I thought it worked well with the shadow colors. And it actually gets warmer towards the light as well. Something like that. Hopefully my head's not in the way. And I'm gonna carry this color a little bit into the vase. Just cover all this. just splashing everywhere. There we go. Fill in some of this. These shadows are kind of blurred. There's no like really hard edges pushing them back. And I wanted to find a little bit of this face, vase, however you want to say it. I think it's important to cover all these little white spots that you're seeing because, in my opinion, I find them distracting. Again, because it's partly using natural light, that's why these shadows are so bright and blue. If it was just inside with the windows closed, then I don't know. I don't think these blues would be as apparent. A little more on the flowers. It's a little bit of thicker paint now. This one is facing the window, so it's a little more cool than perhaps this one. This one also is kind of facing the window, so it is a little more cool. And it gets warmer and darker in the center. There is a clear separation of values between this flower here and the one behind it. So I'm going to try to lighten it up and bring it forward. Lighten it and warm it a little bit. Always stepping back and checking. So these colors back here are a desaturated kind of greenish yellow. And one of the ways I desaturated it was by adding a little bit of white. And it's still getting a little bit darker and a little bit warmer towards the center of the flower, even when it's turned around. these greens. Come on over here. And there's even a little bit on top. Squinting, making sure the values are pretty close. Okay, I'm gonna clear off my palette a little because I want to get these warm parts down again, and I don't want to muddy it up with anything cool. Okay, let's get some of these warms. So for my yellows, a lot of people have trouble with yellows because they're not quite as opaque as they want. They're not bright enough. And there's a couple things. I use a cadmium-free yellow gouache, which can be found, I think, at Dick Blick's. And that's a little more opaque, but I don't know if it's even necessary. I've had luck with just being really careful about keeping them clean, letting the white of the paper do some of the work. And also, everything is relative, so if you want this yellow to look brighter, darken or desaturate what's around it. Maybe work with the complementary color, which would be a purple. In this case, it's kind of a bluish purple since it's got some yellows and oranges. Mixing some of these greens, which right here is actually a kind of a desaturated blue. Adding a little bit of red in with the mix. And then what I like about these flowers too is that the stem kind of changes colors as you go down. So it starts out very cool and then it's kind of doing this kind of ombre gradient effect going down, getting a little bit warmer. Might as well work on some of these other stems. While I have the color. These stems are also wavy. My God, John is here. He's been working from home, which has been interesting. I'm used to having the house to myself, as a lot of you probably can relate to these days. Hi, Al. Thank you. and some of these other stems. There's this one back here. Something like that. And the water line, let's just get that in there. I suck at ellipses. It's actually not quite as dark as I'm putting it, but I can always work on it later. It's kind of a light blue, again, because this is facing the window. Drag this all the way down. Okay, sorry. Now I want to get some, actually let's do some of this up here. I want to get this line in too. It doesn't matter if you go over these stems, I'll be going over them one more time. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle. Can embrace some of the imperfections. Alright, I'm gonna get some of these little center bits, which are the darkest parts. Since this one's in part light, part shadow, I'm gonna do this half a little bit darker. It's actually an even darker spot. So I'm going and using some black mixed with some of this warm red. More on these dark reds that I'm seeing. Might not make sense right now. Hopefully it comes together at the end. All right. Let's see here. Kind of looks like a mess right now, so hopefully I can do something about that. I don't want to paint every petal. So you'll see I just mark little separations between a few of them. There's some of this bright orange here. Pretty much just using pure pigment. Get a little bit quiet when I'm super concentrating. Okay, I'm gonna pop in some of these highlights. A lot of artists save these for last, but I think it gives me kind of a good comparison. I can see where my lights and darks are. Put some of these down here. Not too many. This stem has a lot of warmth on it because this warm light in this direction is hitting it. Hear me stepping back and forth. I think it's really important to not get too close. You need to keep seeing the whole thing. I'm not looking at these as individual stems. I'm seeing it as just shapes all together. So you have like this triangle shape here with a few little cutout bits, and then this. Somehow it just magically comes together, and half the time I'm always surprised because it's so abstract in my mind, and then I stand back and it's just there. So these stems in the water actually get a little bit bigger, and they're not exactly, it's not one straight line through. They kind of shift a little bit. And that's one of the tricks of painting water. feel like it's forbidden to cough nowadays. Stems all hanging out together over here. It's just like one big chunk. And then this one back here is pretty dark, pretty simplified. I'm gonna keep it dark. I'm gonna go over some of these areas where I went over it to paint the top of the vase. And then right where the water is hitting the stems, it's a little bit darker. And this is, I don't know about overall, if all of them are going to be darker like that, but I definitely would take it case by case. And then I'm looking, where else can I put this value and color? I'm going to try to darken up these spots up here. I use my finger to soften them a little bit. I want to get in the background a little bit. Let me make sure. I'm going to try to work on the flowers a little bit. Make sure all the whites are covered. Because what I'm going to do next is use this color in the background to carve out the negative space. So it's important for me to kind of fill out the flowers and even do a little bit of an overlap because I can cut them out. I don't work the same way all the time. It's kind of an experiment. I'm using a little bit of white and some yellow to hopefully get some lighter areas. So this flower back here, where it's hitting the light, is actually going to be lighter than this flower in the foreground. So it's important to kind of simplify it. So some of that up here too. Some of these petals are catching the light. So it's the back petals in this case. Little hints. Okay. It's looking pretty good. There's one more thing. So this stem here is actually casting a shadow on this flower, which is kind of cool. I didn't notice that before, so I want to put that in. And also I can see some of the back of this flower here. Which is gonna help separate it from the foreground flower. They might be moving, I can't really tell. Some flowers move more than others. I find tulips to be really difficult to paint. They kind of move to the direction of the light, I think. I feel like it's getting darker outside. Hopefully it brightens up a little bit more. Okay, cleaned off my palette. I'm actually gonna get clean water because this is what I'm using now and it's pretty thick. Clean water. What's funny is it always starts out pretty high and I use so much water in my painting that it gets pretty low. I think they started almost at the same levels. Going back to, I'm gonna probably switch between my 1 inch and, or 1.5 inch and 1 inch brush. Make sure they're cleaned as well. Actually, I'm gonna use my 1 inch just to be safe. Again, doing a much thicker paint. And I'm using a thicker paint because I know it's exactly where I want it to be. I have everything blocked in. and by using this paint, I can start to pay closer attention to the negative space and the silhouette of the flower. Kind of carve in these petal shapes. These petals kind of curl in. They're a really nice shape. Try to be somewhat careful that you're not going to go over parts with this thick white, because it's going to be hard to work on top of that. You might have to remove it. I'm actually going to darken the background color a little bit. And this is going to darken too. I know that because just from experience painting in gouache a lot. It's hard painting these details with a big brush. I'm just lazy. I don't want to switch. See, it makes such a big difference. Just doing these little cutouts. It's a little bit darker over on this side. I'm gonna move to a smaller brush. I carry this color in to the glass. I'll probably do one more pass on these stems if they're not, if they're looking a little messy. Concentration. So for the background, how it's distorted is that it kind of curves up like this, where there's a straight line here. So I'm bringing it up. A little bit lighter. I'm gonna bring it up on this side too. And there's some of this color and value down here. And then if you're looking closely, you can see a little bit of reflection of the stems. Get some darker darks in here. Done with the background yet. Kind of got distracted with those stems. So let's get back onto it. I'm working wet onto wet because I don't want these lines to be sharp. I want everything to be a little bit fuzzy. Much cooler over here. can see the shadow of some of the petals where it's closer to the wall. A little bit of definition. And I want to keep these soft. I'm going to define this structure a little bit. Still carving out these petal shapes. And I think it's good enough. I'm gonna darken this a little more. Because this shadow is supposed to be darker than here. I'm actually going to try to lighten this a little bit. Yeah, that might be too white. Some purple in there. I notice some of these colors don't mix very well. Drippy stuff off. Actually a lot warmer. there's always a little bit of light. Okay, still need to darken this and desaturate it a bit. Okay, see some of these little drippy spots where the paint's kind of pooled up. I want to get rid of them because it can not look great when it dries. So we're getting there. Finding spots that I want to soften. Your eye is always attracted to like really sharp or contrasty areas. So think about where you want your focus to be and then put a little more love into it. Some of these bright yellows. Make them a little bit warm. So this is where my eye goes when I'm looking at the scene. These really bright yellows. Hitting the light. I got some kind of darker, cool yellows, but that are still bright. So this is when I start to fine tune it. Starting to look for little things to bring out. Actually darker and warmer here. There's little petals, little baby petals. Gotta bring them over here too. Again, I'm trying to just imply at some of the petals and not paint each one individually. Let's warm this up, let it stand out a bit. Since this one's facing outside. And then there's a little bit of that here, because the petals are kind of foreshortened a little bit. So hopefully I can get that looking kind of right. That's a tough one. This is looking all right. Thank you. Sorry, I'm not really looking at the comments because I have to turn around to see them. But I will read over them at the end. Okay. I'm gonna put some of these dark spots in. I feel like I need to move this whole center part up a little bit, like that. You can use a wet brush to kind of, if you're seeing too much contrast or sharpness in one area, kind of blending it out is one way to fix it. some of this cool tone over here. It's getting a little bit lighter out now. I just think the cool bits look really good against the really warm parts. I think that's what attracted me to these particular flowers in the first place. Too much blending. Focus on this. I don't really like what's happening there yet. I want to fix some of this stuff. The dogs. They're wild. You want to say hi? Yeah, look, put your face right here. This is John, my husband. I am working on a cold press watercolor paper. Specifically, I'm using Arches cold press watercolor paper. I know it looks backwards. It comes in a block like this. And then you peel off each individual sheet here when you're done, but it keeps it nice and flat. I prefer cold press with gouache. I find hot press to be a little bit too slippery. Some of these bright reds and oranges again. I do a lot of layering. A lot of back and forth. God. Can you hear John? Getting there. Darken some of these spots one more time. I want to kind of work on this area. It's looking a bit abandoned. It's pretty simplified. There's not a lot going on. Hi, April and Jake. I'm glad you're enjoying it. I need to plan these better. I just know in the group, the Art Refuge, a lot of people were asking about glass. So I wanted to show how I do it. There's all different ways, but it might be helpful. There's some nice warmth coming in down here. Same out here. Right where the glass is meeting the ground, it's going to be really pretty dark. And this kind of gives it a little bit of weight. this color here. Just very thin lines. How long these Facebook streams can go for, or how long I've even been painting. But I'm guessing I'm just about done. Just using a wet brush to kind of straighten some of these lines. It is slightly darker along the edges, but I'm going to use it really watery as a bit of a glaze. Don't want it that green. Kind of a purple color. When you do this, make sure you don't have paint on your hand, because I've totally dragged paint all the way down. And that is not fun. Last bits are just kind of checking little spots that I want to soften. I'm squinting, thinking about what areas to push back. I'm going to push back this. A lot of contrast there. Too dark here. probably work on this a little bit more, do some finishing touches, but it's kind of hard to say how much more I have left. Not too much. I really want to fix this flower. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Let me take this off so I can show you the full setup. Yeah. There it is. Oh, sorry, I'm not good at directing the camera. All right, thanks everyone.